So John and Tina, welcome to Somerset. So I've got to ask, why are you attracted to this part of the country?
It's a really beautiful county. There's rolling hills and countryside and peace and quiet. And I think it's the peace and quiet that we were particularly looking forward to.
So tell me a little bit about this house, this future perfect home.
It needs to be a detached property and it needs to have high ceilings. I'm 6'7", Tina's fairly tall. I like to be able to reach my hand up and not touch the ceiling, ideally. So although character cottages are all very well, I don't really want beams in a house.
Yeah, quite. What else are you after? How many bedrooms?
Probably three bedrooms, and if there's a study or something, that's quite useful as well. We'd also like holiday lets, or a holiday let, because when we move down to here, we're not going to have any income, basically. So we want to generate some income streams.
So what's the priority in your minds? Is it the house or is it the income stream?
I think it needs to be the right house. We need to feel that it is a proper home, not just a box that we're running a business from.
And Tina, what are you looking for with this move?
Well, I'm looking forward to having a house with a fairly big kitchen. I'm a keen cook and I also have a desire to do some cooking lessons for other people, especially because coming from Finland, there are some real treasures in the Finnish cookery that I'd like to show other people.
You might have hit a really good idea then for an income stream. What else have you got in mind?
Well, the horse side is obviously close to my heart, and depending on what we find, if we find a place with enough land, it might be an idea to run a small-scale horse retirement livery.
You've both got some great ideas of future work possibilities. So your budget is £600,000? Do you think that's a realistic budget for all these ideas, what you're after?
I suspect we may have to compromise on something, but if we can get the basics for the £600,000.
We've got three houses lined up to show you. One, of course, is our mystery house, so I hope you've got a bit of an open mind for that one. So shall we get started?
Absolutely.
Come on,
please. For our last property, we're travelling to Compton Bishop, a peaceful village in the shadow of the Mendip Hills, just a 10-minute drive from the world-famous cheese-producing village of Cheddar. The nearest town to the property is Axbridge, which offers many conveniences, including a traditional tea shop and pub, and features colourful houses and striking Tudor buildings. Just 5 minutes' drive away, our mystery house is overlooked by the Mendip Hills. It may be out of John and Tina's preferred pocket of Somerset, but I hope they'll agree it's worth the journey.
It's beautiful.
Do you like the area?
Yes.
We were driving through?
Yes, it's lovely. Mm.
Well, we thought with the mystery we'd push you a little bit further out. Difficult to see your house because it does have that stone garage right in front of it. Actual property itself, the barn, dates back about 200 years, but it's only relatively recently been converted in the last 15 years or so.
All right.
So, what are we thinking before we go inside the house?
Looks promising.
Yes?
Yes.
Yeah, happy with the mystery so far. Nothing's put me off yet.
Brilliant. Yes. Well, I think on that note, we'll start.
All right.
Okay.
This three-bedroom, two-bathroom barn has been refurbished to a very high standard and has underfloor heating throughout. But kicking off in the kitchen, the first question is this. Is it large enough to teach a group of locals how to cook the Finnish way?
Nice kitchen.
Lovely. Yes.
Very homely. Yes, yes.
You could do small-scale cookery in this kitchen. It is suitable.
Yeah. It also has a small utility stroke cloakroom next door as
right.
well.
It is. It's a good kitchen.
Yeah? Yeah.
It is a very nice kitchen.
You're warming to the mystery
so far, but still,
I've got a lot more to show you.
Okay.
The downstairs of the rectangular barn is essentially two large rooms divided by the staircase. And across the hallway is the bright and spacious sitting room.
Now, I couldn't give you a view of your horse from the kitchen.
No, but
what I can do is give you that view.
Very nice. Very, very nice. Yes.
So can you imagine looking out and there's Macy in your paddock right there?
Yes, only a few metres away.
Yeah.
Perfect.
I love that smile. I love that smile. Should we stop there or should we continue?
Oh, let me think. Let's continue.
Let's continue.
Things couldn't be going better, and hopefully the smiles will continue upstairs. The eaves of the barn have been converted into three bedrooms, one of which is currently a study. There's also a family bathroom, and the ensuite master bedroom overlooks the property's land.
most importantly,
the Macy view.
The Macy view.
Nice little window.
Yes.
Yes, it's fantastic. Yeah. It is fabulous.
That's a view to wake up to.
Yes, definitely. That is. Yes.
So the upstairs of this property, I'm not going to lie, it's not huge.
Mm.
We can live with that quite happily, yes. Mm.
Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's more, the downstairs is more important.
Mm. Yes.
To have the space there.
Just do it for me one more time, John. There we go. Hands up. Full approval.
I'm absolutely thrilled with John and Tina's reactions. This tastefully refurbished barn may be out of their original catchment area, but it has almost everything they're looking for. And while it may not offer an option for a holiday let, there's still one more surprise to reveal.
Now, for the icing on the cake. The mystery property does come with a stable block.
Yes.
So you've got a tack room, you've got two stables here.
Right.
Good size.
Yep.
You've also got a turnout area and a shelter as well.
Right, yep.
This is the situation with the land. You've got about half an acre here.
Right,
but we are surrounded by the Compton estate.
Right.
They actually own all the land or around the land behind us, and it's all rented out.
Yeah.
And there is the possibility of having a conversation about renting some of that land.
Oh, right, OK.
If you wanted to buy some land, there are 3.5 acres up for sale.
Right.
How do you feel about this setup?
If there is the possibility of either buying or renting land nearby, then that could be possible.
There's certainly a lot to think about as we head round to the garden, which leads off from the magnificent glass-backed rear of the barn.
So what's going through your mind before we talk numbers?
I'm confused.
Yeah.
It's a really nice house. I'm toying with the how are we going to raise money, income streams, holiday lets, no holiday lets, can we think of something else to do? Mass of thoughts, I think.
Mm. So we've talked about the property, we've talked about the stable block, the possibilities around here of renting land for your horse. How much do you think it's on the market for?
Well, I think this one is going to be slightly above our budget. So I would say 625,000.
Okay.
I'd have to go slightly higher. I think 630,000.
Let me put you out of your misery, shall I? Asking price, £585,000.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
That's good.
Mm.
So it's under your budget.
Mm-hmm.
That would leave you £15,000 if you wanted to go out and either buy land or perhaps rent it.
Mm.
It's going to make you think, that's for sure.
Yes, it has already.
Has it? Have some time, have a wander, do your sums. I'm going to keep my fingers crossed.
Okay.
See you in a minute.
Thank you.
On the market for £15,000 under budget, the change from this converted barn could go towards the extra land needed for horses. The tasteful interior was well received, and the spacious kitchen's perfect for Tina to hold her cookery classes. The property is lacking a holiday let option, but the equestrian facilities here are superb.
First impressions were very favourable. Inside, I had to duck under the first beam, but apart from that, great kitchen, really nice size.
The kitchen is really nice, felt really like me and John could cook in there. Living room, very nice, very impressive. The view from the living room and from the master bedroom is just fantastic. On the downsides, that it comes with just a half an acre paddock is slightly concerning.
We would certainly want to investigate the possibility of either renting or buying more land. And if we could do that, I think this could be a contender, definitely.
Overall, super.
I think we just got that house tour in before the rain sets in. Good timing.
Indeed.
Before it starts to rain. How was it? Have you seen enough?
I think so, yes.
Yeah? Well, that's it. That's all three properties here in Somerset. Mm-hmm.